tonight, the All-American quarterback.
Pat Sullivan from Auburn University.
For all of his life, Patrick Joseph Sullivan was a winner. Born in Birmingham and a three-sport star at John Carroll High School, Sullivan decided to forego college baseball and basketball to play football under Shug Jordan at Auburn. Sullivan rose to the starting quarterback role in 1969 and quickly began breaking school and NCAA records for passing. As a junior, Sullivan led the nation in total offense and average yards per play. He led the Tigers back from a 17-point deficit to win the 1970 Iron Bowl. He was named All-American, SEC Player of the Year, and Gator Bowl MVP. Heading into his senior season in 1971, Sullivan was the leading Heisman vote-getter returning to school. Sullivan led Auburn to 9 straight wins, and on Thanksgiving night, when the Heisman Trophy winner was announced during halftime of the Georgia-Georgia Tech game, Sullivan and his family learned he had won on television like everyone else across the country. Teammates, coaches, and Sullivan's family had a brief celebration in the Auburn Athletic Department before curfew for the Iron Bowl, still 2 days away, shut down the party. Sullivan won 26 out of 33 games and finished his Auburn career with more than 6,200 passing yards, 57 passing touchdowns, and ran for 18 more. His success in college led to a short NFL career. Sullivan played more than 4 seasons with the Atlanta Falcons and wrapped up his career with the Redskins before going into business. Football was in Sullivan's blood, however. He broadcast Auburn games on radio for 5 seasons before joining Pat Dye's staff as a quarterback's coach. There, he guided signal callers like Jeff Berger, Reggie Slack, and Stan White. In 1992, TCU came calling. The Horned Frogs had been hammered by NCAA sanctions. In just his 3rd season at the helm, Sullivan led Texas Christian to a share of the Southwest Conference Championship, the school's first since 1959. Just before TCU's appearance in the 1994 Independence Bowl, Sullivan accepted the head coaching job at LSU, but the school couldn't negotiate a buyout of Sullivan's contract, and he led TCU to another winning record in 1995. Sullivan left TCU in 1997, but not before recruiting a running back named LaDainian Tomlinson. Sullivan soon joined the coaching staff at UAB, where he mentored Darrell Hackney into an NFL player. But his biggest success of the era came not on the field, but off. In 2003, during an operation on his neck, Sullivan was diagnosed with cancer of the throat. He underwent chemotherapy and radiation treatments in April of 2004. Doctors told Pat Sullivan he had won again. He was declared cancer-free.
Put the hat on right now.
He became the 35th head coach at Samford University on December 1st, 2006, the same place where his dad played college football more than 50 years prior. Sullivan is enshrined at the Alabama Sports Hall of Fame, the National Football Foundation Hall of Fame, and the College Football Hall of Fame.